Broadcast of Nightly Business Report on Vermont Public Television is supported in part by Astral Media's Montreal Talk Rock Hot Radio stations, CJAD 800, Virgin Radio 96, CHOM 97.7. By Merchants Bank, Vermont's independent statewide bank, serving the people and businesses of Vermont today and tomorrow. Merchants Bank, statewide and online. This program is also supported by contributing members like you.
You're watching viewer-supported Vermont Public Television, Vermont statewide public television network.
The magical and moving universe of Montreal's Cirque Eloise envelops Burlington's Flynn Center on Tuesday, February 17th and Wednesday, February 18th at 7:30 p.m. A triumph of theatrics, rhythm, acrobatic skills, circus acts, poetry, and music, Nabia creates a world where everything becomes possible and in which reality is transformed into dream. Cirque Eloise, Nabia. For tickets, call 86 Flynn or go to flynncenter.org. As we have previously announced, on February 17th, 2009, Vermont Public Television stations WETK Burlington, WVER Rutland, WVTB St. Johnsbury, and WVTA Windsor plan to permanently end analog broadcasting. This will occur prior to the new nationwide date for the digital transition, which has been moved to June 12, 2009. After February 17th, you can continue to receive our programming over the air using a digital television or by installing a converter box on older televisions. You can also receive our programming by subscribing to a cable or U.S. satellite service. To find a store near you that sells converter boxes, you can visit www.dtv2009.gov or www.vpt.org. To comment or to request more information, please call us at 1-800-639-7811 or write to us at Vermont Public Television, 204 Ethan Allen Avenue, Colchester, Vermont, 05446. Broadcast of Charlie Rose on Vermont Public Television is supported in part by Nicholas Hoare Booksellers, Montreal, Toronto, and Ottawa. Predominantly British bookshops, featuring a broad selection of books and CDs for both adults and children in settings which invite browsing. Information on the web. By Astral Media's Montreal Talk Rock Hot Radio stations, CJAD 800, Virgin Radio 96, CHOM 97.7. This program is also supported by contributing members like you.
Welcome to the broadcast. Tonight, 30 years after the revolution that brought Islamic rule to Iran, we talk to three Iranian Americans, Vali Nasser, Azar Nafisi, and Houman Maj.
Before we start down the path of negotiations and seeing what
they want to eat our rights, is what they say sometimes. I'm not saying it's universal, but I think when it comes to
the. I would add actually something else. The point Azar raises is correct, that you know whether or not it makes sense for a government that has so many economic problems to be putting so much money and emphasis and into a nuclear program and assume so much cost of supporting it. But, and there are some polls done in Iran that suggest that there is a certain degree of support for this. But it's not inconceivable for a population to embrace something like nuclear weapons, nuclear program, particularly when everything else is wrong, to adopt this as a sign of essentially being accomplishing something. We can look at India for
scan function and let the television or converter box find channels for you. Before we address antennas, it's important to know that the new digital signals work differently. Once you've upgraded, coupon at www.dtv2009.gov. To order a coupon, call 1-888-DTV-2009, but it could take 6 weeks or longer to get one. You could also ask a friend or family member if they have an extra coupon they can give you. We hope this program has helped you to upgrade to the crystal clear pictures of digital television.
Analog broadcasting ended February 17th on this Vermont Public Television station and other local stations. If you have questions about receiving our digital channels, please call our DTV helpline at 1-866-424-5483 during these hours. Wednesday, February 18th from 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. Thursday, February 19th from 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. or Friday, February 20th from 5 a.m. to 8 p.m. or visit www.vpt.org.
La radiodifusión analógica terminado el 17 de febrero en esta estación de televisión VPT y otras estaciones locales. Si tiene preguntas acerca de la recepción de nuestros canales digitales, por favor llame a nuestra línea de ayuda de DTV a 1-866-424-5483 durante esas horas. Miércoles 18 de febrero, 5 de la mañana a 9 de la noche. Jueves 19 de febrero, 5 de la mañana a 9 de la noche. Viernes 20 de febrero, 5 de la mañana a 8 de la noche. O visítenos en el web a www.vpt.org.
Hello, I'm Mike DiCirio from the National Association of Broadcasters.
The idea of having a nuclear capacity is a popular nationalistic feeling in Iran.
I'm going to put the usual response to this question. I'll tell you what I mean by that. People say Iranian people are proud people. They definitely are. But aren't French a proud people, or American people, Iraqis for that? So, you know, we are all national when it comes. But the most important thing is that I was talking about this prince from Iran, once a very respected, well-known lawyer. And she turned to me and said, you people in New York and Washington, D.C., why do you think that the problem of the majority of Iranian people, when they wake up in the morning, is not the economy, is not what the president is going to be saying on the news, is not the future of their children, or we'd be so proud to have nuclear, you know? It's not. This isn't that I think the Iranian government and the U.S. government are making so much. I do not think we have any way of knowing what the majority of Iranian people feel about nuclear. We don't even know.
On the civilian or for peaceful uses or not, that there would be a very strong anti-attack feeling because of a violation of sovereignty. Yes.
I would agree with that, absolutely. And it's not that I disagree with Azar so much, but I think that I would agree with you that most Iranians don't, or the majority of Iranians aren't particularly enamored of nuclear weapons. I think when it comes to, the Iranian government has been very clever, in my mind, in how they framed the issue as an issue of rights, as basic rights, that we are being denied our rights for no other reason other than the fact that we're Iran, while Israel is allowed to have them, while, you know, various other countries are.
So well, while Pakistan and India
have them. Pakistan has them. You know, we have this right under the NPT, a treaty that we've signed, and the Americans have signed, and everyone else has signed. Why are they singling us out? They're taking our rights away. Once again, Shias, the martyrs that we are, our rights are being taken away. Right. And that does resonate. So when you ask an Iranian, and this is my own experience of asking ordinary people, so, you know, what do you think? Do you think it's worth, you know, fighting for this right to have nuclear energy or to enrich uranium because it's just a right that we have? Is it worth it? It's like, well, why would they take it right away? They want to eat our rights is what they say sometimes. I'm not saying it's universal, but I think when it comes to...
I would add actually something else. The point that I raise is correct. You know, whether or not it makes sense for a government that has so many economic problems to be putting so much money and emphasis and into a nuclear program, assume so much cost of supporting it. But, you know, there are some polls done in Iran that there's a certain degree of support for this. But it's not inconceivable for a population to embrace something like a nuclear weapons, nuclear program, particularly when everything else is wrong, to adopt